of Daytona, of turn three. It's going to be Slinky, the winner of Pocono, in front of the hometown.
The 99 driver, Carter Joey, will win the second annual New England Birthday Bash at Coca-Cola. Hello everybody, this is Cookie RX, and welcome to the second race of the NRLOA Sinclair ARCA Series. This is race 2 of the NAPA 200 at Milwaukee Mile. Yes, Milwaukee. I never used this track, but I've done some Wolfbox races at this track, so yeah, that's not my actual excuse of why I replaced Indianapolis Raceway Park. IRP, it just doesn't look interesting, and plus I didn't even test it before I even start the series, so. But it's alright though, right? I'll just test new tracks that I haven't used before, and then I'll just replace it as I already started this ARCA series, or any series that I can do specifically. But yeah, Indianapolis Raceway Park is replaced by this track, Milwaukee Mile, for the NAPA 200, so yeah. Sorry that you can't see any short track racing from these ARCA cars, but maybe for other tracks, you might see some short track racing, but for now, we're gonna use Milwaukee for the second race, and yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say. I don't think I really need to talk about the point standing, since again, for every first races that we have done, it looks the same compared to the Daytona race results or any first race results. So yeah, nothing interesting about the points yet, but after that we're done with race 2, things are definitely gonna change, so yeah, that's all. So let's go ahead and get to the command to Fire Dimensions tonight at Milwaukee Mile.
Drivers! Start your engines!
Engines are fired up for the second ARCA race. The pace car is rolling out. Here is your starting lineup. I'll go for our top 10 drivers at Milwaukee. We got day 18 of Tom Abel as the pole sitter. And with him is Timmy Saunders. At row 2 we got Nathan Orman and the 30 of Xavier Smith. Row 3 we got Ryan Durrani and the previous winner Preeti Shah. Row 4 we got Matt Raven Sr. and the 20 of Lauren Martinez. And at row 5 we got Bethany Motocross and the 35 of Chase Miller. So yeah, that's it for the starting grid. The race report will show up right now as we're almost about to get this race started. And the green flag has already been waving for the NAPA 200 at Milwaukee. might tell you this right now, but we might get a caution, an early caution for this race. So yeah, be aware of that. But anyway, we got the pole sitter that will be taking over the lead at lap 2. Behind him is Ryan Durrani in the 25. Nathan Orman at 3rd, who was side by side with Timmy Saunders, and now he is clear for 3rd. Matt Raven Sr. is now with Timmy. Not anymore, but he is clear for 4th place, and he is gonna pass Orman for 3rd place at the inside lane. Freddie Shaw, the previous winner, currently winning for 5th. And Timmy is just side by side with the 12 of Andrew Williams. Orman and Raven Sr. side by side. And Matt definitely takes 3rd place. Actually, they're still side by side. Okay, well, forget about what I said for now. They're still going side by side for 3rd place. So, yeah, the battle hasn't really stopped. Oh, maybe it's stopped right now. But yeah, Matt is at 3rd, and now he is going for 2nd already. So he's gonna go side by side with Ryan Durrani. Freddie Shaw also going to the inside lane. Oh, we got a free wide with those free drivers. And we also got Raven, who is still gaining some positions. He just blocked D11. So yeah, he is currently in a side-by-side battle with the leader / pole sitter. The tire marks. I think someone might spawn out and hit the wall, but okay, I was wondering if the caution is gonna come out, but caution definitely came out, as I was aware of the tire marks at the front stretch. But yeah, caution is definitely out. Tom Abel is still the leader. Matt Raven Sr. will be at 2nd for now, as he will try to continue his hunt for the lead. Pretty Shaw at 3rd. Orman at 4th, and Andrew Williams running for 5th. And there's the rest of your drivers at the leaderboard. We didn't even see who caused that at the front stretch. We'll try to find out if... Oh, the 63 and the 44. They're both out of the race. John Stewart and Zachary Fitzwater Sr. Man. Well, in that case, we're gonna find out of what even happened to the 63 and the 44, so let's go ahead and show the replay of tonight's race. Here's what happened to this first wreck. Yeah, the free wide thing that they were doing, it already looks like that something can go wrong, so yeah, the 55, Sebastian Mayer, was at the middle lane. And yeah, I don't think he has any space to move forward. So as a result of what we're seeing here, actually let me get a better angle of this. Sebastian collects the 63 and the 06, I think, right? Yeah, that's 06. And that puts two of them and Zachary right into the wall. As the 55 spawns out too. So yeah, that's why he collects Zachary and puts him into the wall. And dang, they're pretty much in mid-air after that. And after that we've seen a couple of huge hits into the wall. The 63, he got himself out at wall, but his car is still out of control, so he collects the 23 and hits him. That's Matt Raven Jr. And the 55 and the 06 are still in midair. Thankfully the 15 didn't get collected. I think the 23 continues to drive after spawning the 63 out into the wall. And the 97 and the 69, they both got blocked by the 63. So yeah, that's unfortunate for those two. But they can still drive around this track, so no big of a deal for those two. And the two of them have stopped spawning out while they're driving in two wheels. All four of the wheels are on the track. And yeah, they continue to drive. And Zachary got himself out of that wall. He's trying to move to the inside to not hit the 06 and the 55. But I think he turns left too much. I guess, yeah, he just straight up hits the wall. And yeah, he's definitely stuck there. So that's definitely why that Zachary was out of this race. The 06 hasn't had his engine smoking, but he can continue to drive. But he can drive around this track. But he just had to go to the pit wall and see if the pit crew can fix this car, but unfortunately they can't for whatever reason. I don't know. I think it just says he was out due to a accident or retired. No, I think he retired. So yeah, I guess that's the reason why he was out of this race. So yeah, we're gonna move on and see what's about to happen next at Milwaukee. So let's get ourselves back into the race, and we are back. Tom Abel, the pole sitter, is still leading. Matt Raven Sr. is still at second. The pace car will get itself into the pit lane. The green flag has been waving for the second time. Let's continue this commentary. I think about three of those drivers, they were moving to the inside lane. But I guess that puts pretty Shaw at the outside lane. So yeah, that gives Orman at third, but he is not clear for third place yet. By the way, we're already close to end this race, which is about 8 laps to go at Milwaukee Mile. Matt Raven is still going in front of the 18. So, who might find a way to pass the 18 soon enough. If he rather does it at the backstretch or the front stretch. But yeah. Shaw and Orman are still side by side for third. 6 laps to go at Milwaukee. Nathan is trying to go as much further ahead of the 11 car, but he seems to be struggling a bit. But now he definitely gets third. So yeah, Pri is now at fourth. He almost blocked the 12 just so that Pri Shaw can save herself at fourth. And she is running for fourth. Andrew is still driving at fifth. Which, yeah, I believe he is at fifth place before. Anyway, 4 laps to go to end this race, and Tom is still the leader, so yeah, nothing has changed for the leader or Matt Raven Sr. Now we're going by 3 laps to go to end this race. And Matt has seems to lost the 18's draft. Have lost the draft on the 18. But I think he'll still have some time to pass the 18 soon, but we still wouldn't know when he will actually pass the 18 for the lead, but I know, we're actually close to end this race by 2 laps to go, so I think the 18 is still gonna be the leader if Matt can really pass the 18 soon. 1 lap to go, presented by the NRLOA. Yet nothing has still changed. Christopher Abel has won his first National Series win last week. And now Tom Abel is the leader, as he is going to score his first ARCA win at Milwaukee. He wins the NAPA 200 at Milwaukee Mile. Another Abel family member has won an NR race at the Cookie Rocks channel So, yeah. Congrats to Tom Abel, day team driver, the winner at Milwaukee. And, yeah. That's the end of that race. I'm gonna go save the results real quick. By the way, I fixed OBS by uninstalling and reinstalling it, so hopefully it doesn't look that bad. But anyway, here are the results. Tom Abel, at first, he gets his first ARCA win in the 18. Matt Raven Sr. at second. Orman at third. Pretty Shaw at 4th, Andrew Williams at 5th, Durrani at 6th, Dakota at 7th, Smith at 8th, Morty Gross at 9th, and Saunders, who has started at the front row of Tom, he gets 10th. And here is the rest of your drivers, and the 10 of Rob Ruteman. I think I spelled that right, but I'm still not sure. But, Rob, unfortunately, had a pit stop problem in the middle of the race. So, actually, the pace car has its lights out. So, I might assume that Rob crashed before he head to the final lap. I don't know, that's just my guesses, but that unfortunately happened to the 10, so yeah, that sucks for him. But yeah, that's it. So thank you guys for watching the third race. I think it's gonna happen next month again, because I have other NR races that I want to record. So, yeah, that's why we're getting another 1 week off. 1 week, actually 1 month off. And I can't speak anymore, but you get what I mean. Next month, Talladega, the Menards 200, it's gonna happen. We're already gonna have our second super speedway race at Talladega. It's gonna happen at April 13th. So, yeah. And, I'm pretty sure that we're not just gonna have one race for next month. Instead, we're doing two races for ARCA next month, so. Yeah, it's not just me uploading one ARCA race each month, if you have checked the schedule. So, if you're at the Discord server, but I don't know, some of you are not, but that's fine. I'll usually can give you updates on the next races that I'm gonna do for ARCA and for the other series that I'm doing. So, yeah, just want to let you know that I'm going to do two ARCA races next month, so, yeah. Still gonna have slightly breaks for ARCA, but, again, two ARCA races next month, so, yeah, that's it. Nothing else about after that. But anyway, Talladega is next, and well, for next month, but you already knew that. For tomorrow, the Halls 350 race. That will happen tomorrow for the Chipsoy Cup Series, so stay tuned for that. And yeah, that's about it. So thank you guys for watching, Congrats to Tom Abel as the Milwaukee Mile winner. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for the Willow Springs race. Peace. I can do anything. When I'm dreaming tonight, I can go anywhere. When I'm dreaming tonight, I can be anyone. When I'm dreaming tonight, I can do anything. When I'm dreaming tonight, I can go anywhere. When I'm dreaming tonight, I can be anyone. So don't wake me up.